What to the freedom, a great among the nations, is the glory of this mystery, Christ in you, the hope of glory. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, alleluia, alleluia.
And blessed be his kingdom.
Proclaim and restore. taken from the Old Testament book of 2 Kings, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. 2 Kings, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way to Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent you as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. The company of the prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he said, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Elijah said to him, "Elisha, stay here. The Lord has sent me to Jericho." And he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So he came to Jericho. Company of the prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he answered, "Yes, I know. Be silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of the prophets also went and stood at some distance from them, as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to one side and to the other until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing yet. If you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted to you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them. And Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father!" Chariots of Israel and its horsemen. But when he could not, he could no longer see them, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Who has shown in our hearts stand. We wrap your hand. Number 788. 788.
When they looked around, they saw no one. tell no one about what they have seen until after the Son of Man has risen from the dead. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ
last name, and he said, Sir, draws They lead. The text tells us that it was dark. You see, we need to hold on to this word, because teachers will be quick to tell you words have meaning. Mm-hmm. They're dear brothers. It was dark, and they were going up. As the text says again, they are high mountain. Praise God, back in the day, they had no spotlight. Modern senior lights on them. Got to take their cell phone out and tap that little button for the light to come on. They didn't have none. So it means they were placing their trust in their leader, who's taking us up now to them. Or get ready, at the mountain, in the dark. And as they journeyed up this hill, we can see and appreciate how we speak today about heaven and we look up and we're disappointed. Because here now the text gives us the reason why they were going up the hill. The text tells us that they were going up the hill to pray. Oh, and Jesus now is going into the narrow presence of his Father. And so they ascend to a high place. When they reach up on top of the hill, the text also shares something else. And it was just before dusk. And you know what is amazing in this text? The text doesn't say this, but we know about the characters who were with Jesus. They were all fellows who were familiar with daybreak. They were fishermen who went out that night and came in the morning. And so this new thing of this new life, that shines, some people, I would say, that's just how it would be when the sun rises there. But these kind of moments, but how the sun would rise, they made a living that caused them to be there. Some men will try to justify the act of God a different way. And so I say, up here on the mountaintop, the deck shares with us that all of a sudden their leader, who had gone off a little ways from them, not no longer what, but it's three of them. Praise God, that's when the Higgins has disappeared. He didn't spend back down there. All of us. Bushcraft. Right down, yes. And all of us. What is so amazing to me with this is that as these other two of them, the text says that Jesus began to glow, and his clothes became so white that he no bleach smaller in the room. Scholars suggested that this was a point in Jesus' earthly ministry when his divinity became so strong that it was more God than not just God man. It was more God, and so he glowed. But again, to see him shining, something happened that in yesteryear we were warned about. Peter then said, "Master, let us build three dwelling places. One for you, one for Moses, and and theologians would have shared with us over the years. That is this, that the prophets of old, the Old Testament leaders, prophets, was always shown in pictures of beings as these old fellows with long beards, long white beards. So as Peter did something that I could get from the same to me now as a little boy. Still got to blow in your face. You still got to bounce foot. Amen. Open and open. liberation message will only have power when it works in and through us. You gotta tell us. You have to tell us. And because you have spent time with the Lord, just as Jesus is Lord, oh yes, that mountain top experience caused you to have what a piece of joy share in your world. What you want to do is allow the blessings to be. It is my prayer that we might be people who are not caught up so much that we forget that as God for us, He wants us to share it. Yes. Sometimes we get mixed up and think that when you go in, the whole match is not as much as expected. To as you are blessed to bless others, we think that all the time we talk about money, physical day, I'm trying to tell you today that when you talk Jesus, it's as rich as the physical could be and even better. Because when you can encourage a soul who might have given up because there ain't no place around me you can find where you can walk. When you can encourage a soul that then can see that I can make it from what God has provided around me, knowing that God is still looking for us. Oh, I pray that we will not just be carriers of the Transfiguration story, but those who live it on. God bless you.
Amen.
Peace. Stop.
Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church be truly humbly serving.
That our name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for our bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacrament.
We pray for all the government and all the authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will and all that we want to say.
And our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from iniquity and trust.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
And light perpetual shine upon them. May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our needs and those in heaven. Mighty God,
whom our needs are known before we ask, help us to ask whom you have called to your will, and do the things which we dare not, or in our blindness cannot ask.
Grant us for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The act of penitence. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves of the truth. It's not in us. If we confess our sin, God is faithful and just, and will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins. Almighty God,
our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone.
We are sorry. Life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Save us from the hand of God, and deliver us from evil.
My death is for the body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Thank you.
Maria. Because last Palm Sunday, we were under curfew. We were locked out. You would notice that Father didn't ask you to bring your palms in, because we did not have it. I blessed them the year before. I used half of it at school. I used half of it. Some of the palm was from here. Some was from a center. So now this Ash Wednesday, we will have ashes that was already prepared. Long time ago.
Seven nine zero. 7 7 7.